What's up, everybody? Welcome back to another highly combustible reaction. We're jumping into the next one on our Monty Python journey, the dead parrot. This looked like a fish tank, but apparently there's a parrot in here somewhere, and it might be dead. Let's jump in. Let's check it out together. You guys asked for it. If you guys enjoy it, make sure you get over and show the original poster. Sketch it some love. We're already subbed up. We're going to smash the like button because, hello, look at that ratio. Come on. It's got to be something great. You guys wouldn't have requested it if it wasn't. Let's roll and see what we got. We know it's going to be kind of different humor.
Hello, I wish to register a complaint. Hello, miss?
What do you mean, miss?
Miss!
Oh, I'm sorry, I have a cold. I wish to make a complaint.
We're closing for lunch.
There's been a ton of times in my life where I've called someone the wrong thing. I'm using that from now. I'm sorry, I have a cold.
Complaint.
Oh, sorry, we're closing for lunch.
Never mind that, my lad. I wish to complain about this parrot, what I purchased not half an hour ago from this very boutique.
Oh, yes, sir, the Norwegian blue. What's wrong with it?
I'll tell you what's wrong with it, my lad. It's dead. That's what's wrong with it.
No, it's resting, look.
Look, my lad, I know a dead parrot when I see one, and I'm looking at one right now.
No, that's not dead, it's resting.
Resting?
Yeah, resting. Remarkable bird, the Norwegian blue, innit? Beautiful plumage.
The plumage don't enter into it. It's stone dead.
The plumage don't even come into it. Do I talk about the feathers?
All right then, if it's resting, I'll wake it up. Hello, Polly! I've got a nice fresh cuttlefish for you if you wake up, Mr. Polly Parrot!
There, he moved.
No, he didn't. That was you pushing the cage.
I didn't.
Yes, you did. Hello, Polly! Wakey, wakey! Rise and shine!
Oh, that sound!
This is your 9 o'clock alarm call!
I don't like the sound of a parrot head on the top of a counter. It's horrible.
This is your 9 o'clock alarm call! Now that's what I call a dead parrot.
No, he's stunned.
Stunned?
Yeah, you stunned him just as he was waking up. Norwegian blue stunned easily.
Oh, my lad, I've had enough of this. That parrot is definitely deceased. And when I bought it not half an hour ago, you assured me that its total lack of movement was due to it being tired and shagged out after a long squawk.
Shagged out, huh? The parrot?
He's pining for the fjords.
He's pining for the fjords? What?
Pining for the fjords.
What are you...
Pining for the fjords? What kind of talk is that? Look, why did it fall flat on its back the moment I got it home?
Oh, well, the Norwegian blue prefers keeping on its back. Beautiful plumage.
Look, I took the liberty of examining that parrot, and I discovered that the only reason that it had been sitting on its perch in the first place was that it had been nailed there.
Oh, but of course it was nailed there. I mean, if I hadn't nailed it there, it would have muscled up to those bars and boom!
Look here, mate.
He nailed it in place so it wouldn't muscle
this
its way out of the cage. I like it.
4,000 volts through it. It's bleeding demised.
No, it's pining.
It's not pining. It's passed on.
It's gone on
this
to the next world.
It is no more. It has ceased to be. It's expired and gone to see its maker. This is a late...
It's a late parrot.
It's a stiff, bereft of life. It rests in peace. If you hadn't nailed it to the perch, it would be pushing up the daisies. It's rung down the curtain and joined the choir invisible. This...
What?
It's rung down the curtain and joined the choir invisible.
The choir invisible?
This is an ex-parrot.
Well, I'd better replace it then.
If you want to get anything done in this country, you've got to complain till you're blue in the mouth.
Sorry, Squire, I've had a look. We're right out of parrots.
I see. I get the picture.
Wait, time out. You need to go look. You gotta go look in the back.
If you want to get anything done in this country, you've got to complain till you're blue in the mouth.
Sorry, Squire, I've had a look. We're right out of parrots.
I see. I get the picture.
I've got a slug.
Does it talk?
Not really.
Well, it's scarcely a replacement then, is it?
Listen, I didn't want to work in a pet shop. I wanted to be a lumberjack.
What? I'm sorry, this is irrelevant, isn't it?
He's a lumberjack and he's okay. He sleeps all night and he works all...
That's how it leads. I've seen the Lumberjack song. Don't request that one, guys. That's one of the Monty Pythons I have seen. I definitely have never seen a parrot.
A cut down tree.
So, is the whole movie just one scene, one little, like, cut thing after another? One little skit after another? Is that how it works? Or is there an actual overall movie theme? Somebody let me know. I definitely will probably end up seeing some more of the skits. You guys have requested a shitload of Monty Python. I appreciate you for it. Let's see what we got. Send me some more. We'll keep them on the list as long as they're ones that I haven't seen. Like I said, I've already seen the Lumberjack song. I didn't know that it came after a dead parrot by any stretch of the imagination. Smash the like button if you liked it. The dislike button, but I won't believe you. Make sure you get over and show the original poster. Sketch it some love. We're already subbed up. We've already hit the like button. You should too if you enjoyed it. It's right there inside of the description. Till the next one, highly combustible. You guys be happy, healthy, safe. I'll love you to the moon and back. Peace.